Good evening, everybody. Thank you very much for joining in. This side, Rahul Magan here as a Chief Executive Officer of Treasury Consulting LLP. And today we would be covering a dedicated video on reverse dollar participating swap. This video would be very technical in nature, in the sense like this would tell you that how we can hedge the full swap. Although we already have a video on our YouTube channel which will tell you about how to create a full swap. But this video is in sync with our earlier videos, which we already put on our YouTube channel yesterday. We put three videos on our YouTube channel, and today is 14th of March 2017 when we are putting that. Here we would be covering that how a corporate entity is going to take up a loan and how they are going to hedge, how they are going to create a participation on that. This is going to be a little technical video, so you please listen it very carefully, because this is certainly going to take 15-17 minutes, might be 20 minutes of time. And I would be going little slow. You can see that I am carrying a calculator in my hand, so it's going to be a lot of calculating effort also. So we suggest you should also carry a calculator in your hand. So here we're taking an example. We have a company in India which is Reliance Industries Limited. And suppose they wanted to take up a funding of $1 billion, which is a ECB funding, external commercial borrowing funding. And assuming the funding is being given up by Chase New York. And in India, the funding is carrying, the $1 billion of funding is carried up by Chase India. Right? Now the point of contention. The point of contention is, if Reliance Industries Limited want, they could hedge the same using principal only swap, coupon only swap, and cross currency interest rate. The total is the cross currency interest rate swap. But we are going to hedge this in a little different way. Little different way. But before moving further, let me explain you what do you mean by these all three. Principal only swap means mitigating the foreign exchange risk on the principal. Coupon only swap means mitigate the foreign exchange risk on coupon, which is conversion of fixed to floating and floating to fixed. Third is, the if you add together, these together will known as cross currency interest rate swaps, which is shortly known as CCS. Some people will refer this full swaps also, which are complete hedging. Here we go in a little different way. And we are going a little different in the sense like, here Reliance Industries Limited India is taking the funding, and we would also be using one counterparty, which is Reliance Industries Limited Singapore, that we are also going to use. So there are three steps. Step number one is POS, which is principal only swap. Step number two is COS, which is coupon only swap. And step number three is CCS, which is cross currency swap. Now the point is, here I am dividing this role into two parts. Two parts in the sense like, here I am taking it to, the loan is being taken by Reliance Industries Limited India. And the principal only swap is going to be taken up by Reliance Industries Limited India. Suppose, what is principal only swap? As already told you that Reliance Industries Limited is going to be convert the dollar liability into the INR liability. Because what is the functional currency of Reliance Industries Limited? It is in INR. And henceforth we mentioned reverse dollar, because you are going against dollar. So you are converting dollar liability into your functional currency, which is the INR liability. So what you are going to do, you have a $1 billion for funding which is coming, and we assume the POS rate. Suppose we are taking the current spot rate 67, all that is 66.60. So the POS funding would be rupees 6700 crores. That is Reliance Industries Limited India will get from Chase India. So I'm repeating here that Chase India is going to be fund, is going to fund Rupees 6,700 crore to Reliance Industries Limited India under an agreement which is known as principal only swap. We did a little mistake. we assume that this funding is of $1 billion and this is taken L plus 120 basis point, and tenor of the funding is 10 years. And Reliance Industries Limited is hedging bullet. I repeat, Reliance Industries Limited India is taking that funding of $1 billion at L plus 120. The tenor is 10 years and they are hedging bullet. So Reliance Industries Limited would have three options: principal only swap, coupon only swap, cross currency swap. Rather than going the orthodox way, we are going in a little different way of managing the interest rate, and this is what we known as the participating swaps, right? So what are we doing? That Reliance Industries Limited India, Reliance Industries Limited India is taking a principal only swap of a $1 billion, assuming the POS rate is 67, which they assume. So the funding which they are getting is 6,700 crore funding, right? That funding, Reliance Industries Limited is spending in India, or which is a working capital, which could be Jamnagar refinery, which could be their telecom operation in Jio, and it could be a different stuff which they wanted to invest this funding, right? But here the funding which they are getting is from Chase India, which is JP Morgan Chase India. Now they need to pay some rate, so they would be paying a rate which is known as POS rate. Since we assume that this is a bullet funding, this is a bullet hedging, so and the tenure is 10 years, so they were going to pay the 1 year interest rate every year. So today 1 year interest rate is 3 rupees 18 paisa, and the spot rate is 60. What is the POS rate you are taking? So this is 318 divided by 67 into which is 4.74%. Simplistically, we assume that 4.75% is the POS charge which they are paying. Every year, the POS charge of 6,700 crore into 4.75%, which is roughly 319 crore rupees of PNL debit side funding which would happen to Reliance Industries Limited. Now after 10 years they are going to return 6,700 crores to Chase India, and Chase India will transfer this to in the books of Chase US, and the loan will get settled. Now there is no tension for Reliance Industries Limited India that if INR will go to 70 or it might go to 72, considering a lot of situation and so on and so forth. So Reliance Industries Limited India is safe here. So principal only swap is done. Conventionally, Reliance Industries India also could have done coupon only swap. What coupon only swap is, they are still have one issue, which is LIBOR plus 120 basis point. And LIBOR is always computed quarterly, although you can go ahead for 6 months also. So what are we doing this time? We are adding an ICAP adjustment here. Now here is coupon only swap, but coupon only swap is little different. We are not doing conventional coupon only swap, because if you are going to do conventional coupon only swap, then the issue would be that they are going to fix a swap rate, which is USDIRS, US swap rates. That swap rate must be on a higher side, because currently that has discounted the element of the Federal Reserve hike. What would happen if seriously Federal Reserve do not hike? Then why are we paying the swap rate? So here we are assuming that Reliance Industries Limited is under an assumption that this won't hike, Fed won't hike. So whatever which has been discounted in the US swap rate, this would be an overpayment which would come on the debit side of the P&L. So let's ignore that. So what they are going to do in that, they are going to go to their entity which is known as Reliance Industries Limited Singapore. Because this cap structure is not allowed in India. Had this cap structure been allowed in India, Reliance Industries Limited India would have done that, but this is not allowed in India. So Reliance Industries Limited Singapore would be taking that position, and the counterparty would be same Chase Singapore. Suppose, and why suppose, we already assume that. So since it's a bullet hedging, 10 year US swap is currently trading at 2.75%. And Reliance think that this is little costly. because the Federal Reserve hike has been discounted. So they wanted to go, they seriously not interested in doing so. So what would happen is that this is 10-year swap which is going on. Now they have two options. We already explained you what do you mean by interest rate caps. In the interest rate caps, you're going to create a cap, and if it go higher, then you will get it. If it go lower, then you will not get anything because you already paid. You will not pay anything because you already pay a premium. This 4.75% or the equivalent INR 319 crore has already been coming in the books, which is on the debit side of the P&L. Now we are creating a cap. We left with three options in the cap. This 2.75% is a rate of Thomson Reuters right now. We left with three options. Are we going in the money? Are we going at the money? Are we going out of the money? We are going at the money right now. If we would have gone in the money, then we will do the cap at 2.2, 2.3. Of course, we need to calculate the volatility of that, and that volatility will certainly take some time to calculate implied vol. So we are assuming that we are going at the money right now. If we are going at the money, assuming the premium is 1.45%. Assuming the premium is 1.45%. Now I'm going to write here, the scene would be cap buyer would be Reliance Industries Limited, Singapore. Cap seller would be Chase, Singapore. Amount would be $1 billion. Premium would be 1.45%. So it stands at, I think, $14.45 million. So premium in dollars $14.50 million. That is, and since we are going at the money, so we are taking a cap which is at the money cap, which is 2.75%. Now the point is, what would be our reference? Now the reference is 6 months LIBOR. How much is the tenure? 10 years. How much would be the strike? Strike would be 10 into 2, which is 20. We know that LIBOR is quoting 3 months, but we are converting this into 6 months. So we have to add ICAP adjustment. And what would be the ICAP adjustment? That ICAP adjustment is assuming 15 basis points. So that ICAP which we are adding, which is 15 basis points, 0.15%. That additionally would come in the cost of Reliance Industries Limited, because you are converting 3 months LIBOR to 6 months LIBOR. So for a $1 billion transaction, that 0.15% is $1.5 million. So the total cost of the cap in the books of Reliance Singapore would be 14.5 plus 1.5, which is 16, and both are one-time cost but payable upfront. Before moving further, let me repeat your transaction. Reliance Industries Limited would like to go for external commercial borrowing. They are taking $1 billion from their funder, which is Chase New York. Chase New York is putting a rate L plus 120, which is LIBOR plus 120, quarterly settled. Tenure is 10 years, and they wanted to do bullet transaction. So if it is quarterly, then 10 into 4, which is 40 transaction. But Reliance Industries Limited is not interested. They wanted to do it into a semi-annual transaction. Henceforth, we need to add ICAP adjustment. Sitting today, 3 months to 6 months stands at 0.15%, that you can very well check from Thomson Reuters. Right? Now, there are multiple ways Reliance Industries Limited can hedge that. One of the ways is principal only swap, coupon only swap. If we add total, if we add this, then we come up with which is cross currency interest rate swap. Now we are involving two parties, which is Reliance Industries Limited India and Reliance Industries Limited Singapore. Reliance Industries Limited India is doing a POS transaction, which is principal only swap transaction. They wanted to fix the exchange rate on the principal, and what are they doing? They are taking the POS rate 67. If you are thinking that taking POS rate 67 is a mistake, then you are wrong. You can take even 79. It is a zero-sum game. Because if you take 79, here it would be 79. And here it would be 7,900 crores. If you take 100, it would be 10,000 crores. And here it would be 100. So ultimately, it is a zero-sum game. Mathematically, it's a zero-sum game. Choice is yours. Henceforth, this is known as POS rate. So POS funding would be happen at 6,700 crores. Now that 6,700 crores, Chase India would be given to Reliance Industries Limited, which they are using for could be their geo operation, could be their telecom operation, and maybe their petroleum operation, wherever they want it to be. To hedge this coupon only swap, which is the float liability of L plus 120, because Reliance is still facing a float of LIBOR, and they are not sure whether Fed would hike the rate or not. But one thing which they are sure that at least in this year they are not going to hike the rate, right? So what they are doing, they have a conventional way. Conventional way of doing it that they could go to a bank and they could fix this by converting this float into a fix, which is USD swap rate. But they don't want to do that. So what are they doing? They are involving their counterparty, their legal entity, which is Reliance Singapore. Reliance Singapore contact Chase Singapore, because ultimately is a Chase New York, Chase India, so they would be contacting Chase Singapore. Chase Singapore will say that 10-year swap is currently quoting as 2.75. Why I'm taking 10-year swap? Because why are we taking 10-year swap? Because it's a bullet transaction. So we are going at the money. Assuming at the money is 1.45%. Now this 1.45%, which they are taking, and of course this is using options theory, which is Black-Scholes, right? Who would be the cap buyer? Reliance Singapore. Who would be the cap seller? Chase Singapore. What would be the amount? $1 billion. What would be the premium? 1.45%. How much the premium which is coming? 14.50 million. How much the cap which we are maintaining at the money cap? 2.75%. What is the reference? 6 months LIBOR. Remember, LIBOR is quoted quarterly, but here we are converting into 6 months. You can do so. For that, you have to pay something which is ICAP. ICAP is amongst best brokers we have. That ICAP is 0.15%. So 0.15% into $1 billion, which is 1.5. That is again a cost. If I wanted, I could have add this 1.5% here. Ultimate number is going to come the same, but I am differentiating this as to make you clear. So the total payout in the books of Reliance Singapore is 14.5 plus 1.5, which is $16 million. Now situation is same, which we already did. Now it's a cross currency, full swap. Principal only swap is did by Reliance Industries Limited India. Coupon only swap is done by Reliance Industries Limited Singapore. And payout after 6 months, after payment or payoff, after every 6 months would be same, which is index rate minus strike rate into notional into basis count. Assuming the 6 months LIBOR after 6 months turned out to be 3.5%. And this 6 months we and here we are taking basis count. Let me write that the basis count we are taking actual to 365, 360. And that turned out to be 3.5%. So the payout which Chase to give to Reliance would be 3.5% minus 2.75 into 1 billion, assuming the 6 months is 182 days divided by 360. So it would be (3.79). Let us check again. $3.79 million, which is roughly $3.8 million of payout which would happen. This is a classic case which we wanted to cover, because yesterday we posted 3 videos on interest rate risk. In this, we not went conventionally, we went unconventionally, and we kept the total cost floating in our P&L. We did everything. We converted principal only swap. Here we converted the principal liability. The floating liability which we converted using our offshore entity, which is Reliance Singapore, because great Reserve Bank of India will never allow you to do such transaction. Once you will consolidate, things would automatically be same. So Reliance Singapore is doing with Chase Singapore. And at the end, you are taking the cap, you end up $3.8 million. Henceforth, we mentioned this as a reverse dollar participatory swaps. And reverse dollar participatory swaps will not only allow you to convert to protect the FX risk, but also to convert the floating liability into a fixed liability using a cap. We would thank you very much for that and hope you like this video. You know our website www.treasuryconsulting.in. Our mobile number is 9899242978. My Skype ID is Rahul5327. My email ID is rahul.magan@treasuryconsulting.in. Don't forget that 31st March, we are launching our presentation of the company. Company corporate desk is already in the public domain. Company director desk is already in the public domain. And hopefully the February 2017 newsletter is coming tomorrow's evening, right? Or maximum by Tuesday, maximum by Wednesday evening, right? 31st March, we are launching a beautiful presentation which would be talking about the treasury capabilities of Treasury Consulting LLP, which would only for the corporates. And of course, we would be launching the video of that on our YouTube channel, right? And again, not to mention, we are launching our fixed income platform. And Treasury Consulting LLP would be the second company in India who would have the fixed income platform. And with this, we would be in the league of CNBC, ET Now, Bloomberg TV, Thomson Reuters, and Value Research Insight. And of course, as soon as we are done with the fixed income platform, we would be launching our third magazine, which is on mutual funds. Thank you and have a wonderful time ahead.